They must do without skipper Martin Cool and central defender Craig Short, both cup-tied in this competition. Simon Coleman comes in at centre-half, with Dutchman Richard Kluivert in midfield. Mark Patterson has overcome his rib in the First Division, having been relegated from their Premier League last season. They have no current... And it looks good, and it's in! A goal! Just an interception, goes on a run here. And a good ball to find Kitson. And back it goes towards Gabbiadini! Derby's Italian connection pays off! A splendid goal for Arthur Cox's team. Marco Gabbiadini scores his 16th goal of the season. And his Italian dad, watching in the stands here, will be delighted that his son has made his mark in this Anglo-Italian final. And in Cremonese's team can regain their lead here from the spot. But Taylor has produced a marvellous save. Well, he almost did, but it was a very, very accurate penalty right. And the ball went away, and I think we'll see it here. Look at that. That's a good-looking ball. Forsyth's got to work some here. Tentoni's clear. It's a goal! And one of the men of the match. Point of view, the Anglo-Italian Cup has been nothing but good news, even if they did lose the final itself. Too often that the losers climb Wembley's famous staircase to greater applause than the winners, but that's happened today with so many Derby fans here. Tumultuous applause for Mickey Forsyth and the Derby team. They may be losers' medals they're receiving from the guest of honour, the Right Honourable Douglas Hurd MP, but really, Derby County have come out of this competition well.